This episode is brought to you by Skillshare. Hey guys, salut, this is Alex. So a bit of a different setup today. I'm in the garden, I'm outside just because it's summertime. And basically for me, summertime only means one thing, it's time for a stir fry. The seasoning basically needs to be completely redone. The most important question of all this, how non-stick can we go? Teflon, non-stick, can we go above? It's probably too much, okay, but let's do this. Yeah, so the first operation is basically to remove all the dirt, all the rust, and just scrub everything off with vinegar, salt, and just elbow grease. It's probably 20 times faster. And probably 10 times more dangerous. Okay, here's a quick tip. As soon as you feel like the pan is clean enough, just mix in a bit of oil along with vinegar and so make a slurry and finish the pan with it. And by doing so, you will basically prevent your pan from having, you know, that thin layer of rust or just spots of rust everywhere. So if you did good, if you really committed to it, this is the kind of shiny surface that you should get at the end. All the marks, all the rust is gone, and this is the blank material, the blank canvas we need to work on and start building a seasoning. You clean this. We're gonna create that tough, resistant and non-stick coating on the inside using linseed oil. This is food safe linseed oil, which is the exact same stuff as flaxseed oil. I know that in the US you might be used more to flaxseed oil, so please use it. I'm gonna drizzle a good amount of oil inside the wok and then really thoroughly wipe it out until there is apparently nothing left, and then I'm gonna bake it. Let me start all this and we'll come back to science just afterwards. You know science is coming. So it's been in the oven for about an hour. Let's just turn it off. And I'm gonna leave it in there just to slowly come down to room temperature. This is what I got after one coating. I've got this slightly blue tint to it. I'm gonna start the process again. This is layer number one. And now it's going back in the oven for another hour of cooking, followed by another hour of just waiting forever. Right, so I think it's time to share with you a primer on what seasoning actually is. Seasoning is not, first of all, about flavors, it's not about salt and pepper. And also, seasoning is not about leaving a dirty old, you know, layer of leftover grease at the bottom of the pan. It's not about this. No, seasoning is a dry, hardened coating that sits on the inside of a pan, and that is basically super useful. One is to protect the pan from rusting, since it's only applied to cast iron and carbon steel pans, which are prone to rusting. And second, it's making the pan non-stick-ish. And I guess that's basically the first coating in terms of knowledge, seasoning knowledge, that I wanted to rub you with. I don't rub anybody, okay? I don't do this. It needs to be super clean before you whack it in the oven. Otherwise, it leaves marks everywhere. The thinner you go, the more inexistent the oil coating is on the pan, and the better the polymerization is gonna perform in the oven. So it's getting darker and darker. This is the third coating that I did. I'm back on the workbench, applying the fourth one. The fourth. Layer number five. So basically, in the past, to season my pans and my skillets, I use any oil, like random cold press, unfiltered, random oil. But recently, I was browsing the internet and I stumbled upon an article from Cheryl Kenter, an article about seasoning pans and about oil, and basically did open my eyes on oil polymerization. Hi there.
Hi, Alex.
So I'm working on this seasoning episode. People sometimes use this type of oil, or sometimes they use lard, or sometimes they use high smoke point oil or low smoke point oil. So when I read your article, eye-opening for me, because I thought, okay, a logical approach to seasoning. How did you came up with this idea?
Well, I'm a nerd, and I had the same problem you had. So I started reading journal articles about chemistry. Mm-hmm. And I have no background in chemistry. Slowly it started to point to the same thing. And when I tried it, it worked.
So you start with flaxseed oil, right?
Here's the thing. Certain oils you don't use for cooking. Flaxseed oil is one of them. And you don't heat oil above a smoke point or it's, you know, carcinogenic. But ironically, it's that exact process that makes the oil glass hard. Mm-hmm. So the exact thing that you don't want to happen inside your body, you do want to happen mm-hmm. on the surface of the pan. So you take the oil with the lowest temperature mm-hmm. that you can't heat beyond,
okay.
and you heat it way beyond that temperature, mm-hmm. and it becomes glass hard.
Thank you so much, Cheryl, for all this.
Thank you, you too.
See you, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Oh, okay. This is coating number 6, the final one. It's very smooth, it's beautiful. Now I'm not saying I'm not happy with the Cheryl Kenter's method, but in the end I feel like the coating is quite light in terms of color. It doesn't mean it's bad, but it's not black and dark and deep and rich. I just wanna go just a tad wilder, and for this I'm gonna use a gas stove. At the moment, it's creating way too much smoke. Yeah, so basically I'm gonna step outside and I'm gonna continue this experiment in a safer-ish way, okay? Let's step outside. Right, let's do this. I can't open it with my gloves. I don't think it's gonna blow up. Is something gonna blow up? Well, maybe. I'm just a f***ing cook. So I feel like I definitely got a darker coating on this pan. The thing is, at the moment, it's not perfectly smooth, which means that I'm gonna head back to the studio and find a solution for that. I might have something already. I might have something. So Skillshare is an online learning community with over 28,000 classes in design, business, and of course, cooking. So you know, I love learning so much. You probably know that already. It just fuels my creativity and my curiosity. I found Skillshare to be just the perfect place for that. At the moment, I'm following two classes. The first one is a pizza course about making thin crusted pizza. You know, I'm a big fan of Neapolitan pizza, so the fluffy kind, but it's always good to learn on a new technique. And the second class is a butchery class taught by Pat LaFrida himself. He's an OG butcher in the US, to understand beef cuts and also to order both at the butcher and at the restaurant more cleverly. Skillshare has a premium membership which is pretty affordable at less than $10 a month, and for this price you get unlimited access to all the classes and all the communities that are just right for you. So if you want to give it a try, the first 100 of you guys that hit the link in the description box down below will get a 2-month free trial. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. The coating on the pan at the moment is not perfectly uniform. In the very center, it's perfectly black and it's very smooth, and it's about to get even smoother. I've been doing a bit of DIY. If I want to increase the ability of that pan to be non-stick, it has to be as smooth as possible. Can't feel any irregularity. It's just so smooth. Hold on a second. the sound. Okay, let me put it back together and let's make that egg test, because you know I'm gonna be cooking an egg in this, for sure. Oh, what if I were to flip it around? Is that better than a Teflon pan? The annoying geek inside me says on a brand new Teflon pan, you don't need to add even a smidgen of oil. At the same time, the cook just says that there's no chemical, it's just like a nice, very hard polymerized surface on which you cook things with a very reasonable amount of oil. So to me, and I'm gonna say it, I think it's better than a Teflon pan. Now, obviously this is very biased. I'm willing to hear what you guys have to say about this. Please use the comment down below. It's always amazing to hear from you. I'm gonna have this egg. Now, obviously I didn't went through all these efforts just to make myself an egg, even though it's very good. It's crispy. Now the reason why I took so much care with this seasoning, the reason why I committed so much, is because I want to make stir fries. I don't want to make any stir fries, I want to make barbecue stir fries, and I don't want to make barbecue stir fries over any barbecue, no, I want to make them over an appliance, a contraption that I'm gonna be building in the next episode of this mini barbecue stir fry series. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, you know what you gotta do, like, share, subscribe, spread this like butter on a non-stick pan. So until next time, bye bye, salut.